Akunle for minister, Iyade Kunle superstar.
Oh mama,
mama mi to ta go, Kunle di go bilaye.
Iyade yo,
mommy mi e se ku oro omo.
Welcome back to my channel, and this is Alpha Glam. And with me here is my mom. Yes, she's having a full makeup section for her birthday shoot. And jumping right into it, I'm using the Meron Skin Prep to prep her face, using it to control the oil and sweat on her face. Then afterwards, I'm going into my Miss Matic moisture portion. Yes, I'm using that to moisturize just under eyes, so you can notice I'm moisturizing just under eyes. Then moving into the number 7 primer, I'm using that on her T-zone also to mattify her face and control oil on her face. So I'm blending it into her T-zone. Now using the MAC foundation in NW47, I'm using my foundation brush to apply first on her face before going into my beauty blender to apply it, to blend it on her face. I noticed this foundation dries up quickly, so I apply at a particular part of her face, then blend, and that is what I did all over her face. And the gist here is that my mommy is having her 50th birthday, and this is the first time she'll be sitting down for a full makeup glam. It has never happened, and you can see the joy and excitement on her face, and it was really nice doing it on her. So just continue watching, and I hope you like the outcome. So yes, I'm still blending. Yeah, blending. I'm turning her throws up her eyes, hoping to blend on her eyes properly. So now this is the ColourPop concealer. I'm using that on her T-zone, using it on her under eyes, bridge of her nose, her forehead. And I'm going to be blending it also with my beauty blender. Yes, remember to blend, guys. Blending is key. So just blending everything all together. Yes, still blending. She doesn't want to raise up her eyes. She's always scared of anything that wants to touch her eyes. Well, it's normal. So I'm sure that's what you're laughing about. Yeah. So this is me still blending. Now I'm using my Laura Mercier setting powder to set her face. Yes, I'm just using it on the places where I lighted, and I'm using a brush to apply it. I'm not going with my full method because I noticed that for older women, you don't want to apply too much of powder on their face. So I'm just going right into my setting powder immediately. I'm blending the other eyes to avoid creasing there. Then using my brush to apply the setting powder on the eyes. So that's what I did on all the places I lighted on her face. Then I'm going into the MAC powder. Yes, I'm getting into the MAC powder, forgotten the shade. I'm using it to set all over her face, so to make sure everything rhymes all over her face. And that is what I am doing right now, using the powder all over her face. I'm moving on into the Lady V powder palette. I'm using that to contour her nose. I didn't want to go into a cream contour, so I'm just basically using a powder contour for her nose. And this is me brushing up her brows and drawing her brows. This is the first outline of her brows, drawing it and also filling it in. So another gist is that my mommy doesn't like brows like this. She prefers all those ones in the 90s, all those ones with the line alone. But I will just have to convince her to make me draw this. So I'm filling in the brows with my brow pencil. And also I used the blot brow gel just to brush it up and make it lighter. And this is me going into my concealer, a lighter concealer, first under the arc of her brows. Then I'm still using a lighter concealer, yes, at the beginning of the brows, then also to the other side, a lighter concealer under the arc of her brows. Yes, just to outline her brows and make the brows look cleaner. So this is me blending it out with a blending brush. Then also I don't like cleaning the top of my brows, but I just had to do it today so that everything comes out really nice, and I think I like the effect. But on a normal day, I don't like cleaning the top of my brows. This is me just using my concealer on the top of my brows, and I'm using a shade that is really close to her foundation color. If you can notice, you can't see the mark or the colors there. And I'm using my blending brush to just clean up. So now this is me applying an eyeshadow from the Juvia's Place eyeshadow palette, and I'm using a black eyeshadow to line her eyes. I did not go into the liquid eyeliner because I know it will not really come out so nice on her. And now I'm cleaning up the excess powder. Yes, I'm just dusting it off, and I'm using the Masking Finish Mineralized Powder just to set all over her face. And this is the Kiss Beauty setting spray. I'm giving her a bath. I'm sure she would have been like, it's too much. And this is me applying a lip stain in Soak Soda, the Zaron lip stain. So I did not bother to line her lips. I just went straight into the lip stain, and this is me blending it. Yes, I'm blending with a pointed blending brush, and you can see it looks really nice on her. So yes, I initiated my mom to the club of the gloss girls, and this is her on gloss. She herself likes gloss, she uses gloss every day, and this is her checking herself out. And I think she has seen a picture of a makeup where they highlighted the top of her brow, so she was asking if I was going to do that for her. I told her I did that already. So this is a blush. Yes, I'm using burnt orange from my Morphe palette just to give her a little bit of color, and this is her smiling. She's saying thank you, she loves it. Hope you like it.
My mom and her birthday, she's marking her 50th birthday, and this is our first time of having her makeup done. Like, never ever 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 have you done this makeup before, but she looks so good. What do you think, guys? She looks good.
Yes, so this is my sister just giving her the Snapchat effect and everything, and we are moving into the gele. Yes, so I made 3 pleats first on her head. Yes, I just made 3 pleats on her head, and I tied it. The longer hand came under while the shorter hand came on top. You can tell me if you want a gele tutorial. I'll go in depth and give you a full gele tutorial. We are basically rushing in this video, so I had to just rush it, and I can't give you something so detailed, but the little you get here, I'm sure it will be enough to have at least a substantial knowledge about gele. So now that is the shorter end of the gele, and I'm forming my pleats. Ah god, tying gele is hard, like, oh my god, especially when it is a new gele, but I'm trying my best to just get a hold of it. So this is me just making pleats. I think that's the third pleat, and I made up to 6 of it. Yes, this is the 6th pleat. Then this is the longer hand. I'm putting it on top of the short hand, and I'm asking her to hold it, and I'm tying it at the back. I'm sorry guys, I could not make a video of how I tied it at the back. But if you want a detailed gele tutorial, just let me know. I'll make the videos and show you how I tie and everything. So I'm making my pleats on top of the longer end of the gele. So this is just me making pleats and trying to tie it totally. Yes, I almost fainted by tying this gele. Like, you see my facial expressions. Yes, so this is me trying to knit in my gele, and there's something about me. My hands don't leave the gele till I feel like it is perfect enough. Even though at the end of the day, I always feel like it's perfect enough. But yes, but this still looks good, and I think the effect is so nice. So this is me just checking it. So thank you for watching this video. I hope you like it. Don't forget to give me a thumbs up. Please comment, like, and subscribe. Subscribe, guys.